One call from a killer? Evening, everybody. I'm Jack Affington.
And I'm Cheryl Parker in for Cherie. A person who called to report a man lying in the street is now the number one suspect in a stabbing death. News 5's Laura Borges is live with a new twist. Laura.
Yeah, detectives are busy as we speak. And while they talk with a person of interest, family members remember the victim. His mother found him on the front porch. That man struggled to make it home after being stabbed. He made it all the way to his front porch and died just feet from her window.
He's going to be missed very much.
Brian Tucker was one of David Dolliver's best friends. Tucker's wife and daughter helped him set luminaries around the porch and sidewalk where Dolliver died just days ago.
He was always smiling. Dave was happy-go-lucky, and you couldn't not laugh around Dave.
Dolliver died after being stabbed in the neck last Thursday. Police originally arrested a friend he'd been drinking with, but today the grand jury obeyed the prosecutor's request to ignore the murder charge and let that man go. Meanwhile, detectives honed in on another man.
Everybody's saying his friend did it. You know, now it's just trying to find out who did it and, you know, if the person they have in custody now is actually the one that did it or what's going on with that and what actually happened that night, because no one really knows.
On the day of Dolliver's funeral, friends reminisce.
He was a good person, very good person, loving.
He was silly. He would make the kids laugh.
The vigil, a statement of his personality.
It is really, really amazing. It just shows, you know, how wonderful a person he is and how many parts that he actually touched.
Most here can't help but wonder who slayed their loved one.
I believe what comes around goes around.
I'd rather live in jail for the rest of my life than live with the guilt of murdering somebody so nice and loving.
Now, police did execute a search warrant just a short time ago and did recover property from that home. As for Dolliver, his funeral will be tomorrow morning at 10 a.m. Reporting live downtown, I'm Laura Borchers, News.